Hi everyone, we will show you how to do the two-star alignment on the Nexus DSC today. As you can see, I set up a telescope on AZ100 mount, and now we will do the two-star alignment. First thing we do, we set the telescope pointing vertically, and then we go to align, altitude reference, and the scope should be pointing plus minus 5 degrees from a vertical position. Once you do that, you press OK, and then we select the first alignment star. For tonight, we use Gina, and which is currently located at approximately 67 degrees in altitude and 311 degrees in azimuth. So what we need to do, we need to point the scope at Gina and center it in the eyepiece. If you have a reticle eyepiece, then it's best to use one with the reticle. If you don't use a scope with a reticle eyepiece, then you can use high power eyepiece and defocus the star image until the diffraction picture takes most of the field of view, and that way it is much easier to center. So we just move to Gina, and once it is pointing at Gina, we press OK. Then we select the second alignment star, and the second alignment star for tonight we use Acrab, and it is currently located at approximately 52 degrees in altitude, and it is a good enough separation in azimuth, though we usually suggest to use stars that are separated by at least 60 degrees, but best it is to use two alignment stars separated by 90 to 180 degrees. Acrab is currently at 77 degrees in azimuth, so it is a really good separation. So now we move to Acrab, and again we center the star into eyepiece, and once it is in the center, we press OK. And Nexus DSC report that successfully aligned, and now we can use Nexus DSC to locate objects. We press escape twice, and then we go to menu find from catalog, and if you want to locate some Messier objects, we can use its index, and currently the index for Messier catalog is 36. So we just type 36, and as you can see, Messier is selected. Press OK, and then we can go and find some Messier objects. So if we want to see M3, then we need to move until the azimuth becomes close to zero. Then it shows us that we need to move down 25 and a half degrees in altitude. And once those numbers are close to zero, you can look through the eyepiece, and it will be in the eyepiece.